Hello everyone, welcome to NG Classes YouTube channel for a video lecture series on signals and systems. In this video lecture, we'll consider finding the inverse Fourier transform of x of j omega, which has been given as j omega divided by 2 plus j omega square. So the task is to find the inverse Fourier transform. For few of the terms, we make use of the properties and I can find the inverse Fourier transform very easily. So first, what I do is, we'll start with the solution. So let me write first, we know that Fourier transform of e to the power minus 2t u of t. So what is the Fourier transform of this? This is a very standard signal, e to the power minus 2t u of t. The Fourier transform of this is going to be 1 divided by 2 plus j omega. So this is the standard Fourier transform. So now for this, what we do is I'll make use of frequency differentiation property. Let me write frequency differentiation property. Frequency differentiation property. So I'll make use of that property and I'll try to reduce this further. So if I make use of that, as per the property, it is minus j into t e to the power minus 2t u of t. That gets equal to Fourier transform of this is equal to d by d omega of 1 plus 1 divided by 2 plus j omega. So this is what the differentiation property says. So I'll just multiply with minus jt in time domain. It's as good as differentiation of the signal in frequency domain. So I have made use of that signal. I made property. So now that gets reduces to minus jt e to the power minus 2t u of t. This is equal to, so now I'll take the differentiation. Differentiation of this leads to, so it is first what I have to do is I'll just keep denominator as it is. Differentiation of the numerator, it's a constant, turns out to be 0 minus what we have to do is keep the numerator as it is and differentiation of the denominator. 2 is a constant, it is 0. J omega, differentiation of that with respect to omega is j. That gets divided by denominator square. So this concept comes from mathematics. So here I have made use of that and I got this answer. So now minus j and minus j, I can cancel them out. So as you can see, I just make use a different color. Minus j and minus j, I can cancel them out. Therefore, I would get e to the power minus 2t u of t. That is equal to, the Fourier transform of this is equal to 1 divided by 2 plus j omega whole square. So if you look now, in the numerical, it has been given that 2 plus j omega square is there in the denominator. So now we are getting that term in the denominator. So that is the trick we have to make use. And we also need j omega in the numerator. So how can we get j omega in the numerator? For that, I have to make use of the differentiation property again, but in time domain. Is that okay? So now here we have used a frequency differentiation property. So now what I do is I'll make use of the differentiation property in a time domain. So that property, I'll just write a sentence using time differentiation property. So this is very important, time differentiation property. So if I make use of that, I can reduce this further. So that time differentiation property says that d by dt of the signal, that is t e to the power minus 2t u of t. So this is equal to, the Fourier transform of this is equal to जे ओमेगा इनटू द सिग्नल दैट इज 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 प्लस जे ओमेगा स्क्वायर. इज दैट ओके? सो दिस इज व्हाट वी आर लुकिंग फॉर, जे ओमेगा डिवाइडेड बाय 2 प्लस जे ओमेगा स्क्वायर इनवर्स फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ दिस वी आर लुकिंग फॉर, इट इज दिस. इज दैट ओके? देयरफॉर आई कैन राइट द आंसर एज, देयरफॉर द आंसर x ऑफ t, because x of j omega was given, so now I am taking the inverse Fourier transform. X of t is nothing but this signal, that is d by dt of t e to the power minus 2t u of t. So now I can take the differentiation of this in time domain and I can get the answer straight away. So what could be the answer? So now what I do is, I'll just keep t as it is. It is product of terms. So keep t as it is and take the differentiation of the second term, e to the power minus 2t. Differentiation of that is minus 2 e to the power minus 2t. Is that okay? Plus, now keep the second term as it is, e to the power minus 2t, and differentiation of the first term. Differentiation of t is nothing but 1. Is that okay? So now I have taken the differentiation and I'll just keep the unit step signal u of t as it is. So moving further, I can just reduce this further. What I can do is, I'll take e to the power minus 2t out. I will be left with 1 minus 2t, e to the power minus 2t has been taken out, and u of t left, it is there as it is. So finally, therefore, x of t is equal to 1 minus 2t e to the power minus 2t into u of t. So this is how I take the inverse Fourier transform. The very important things to remember in this numerical is, I have to make use of frequency differentiation property and time differentiation property. If I can make use of those properties, I can get the answer very easily. I solved this numerical step by step. I hope you people have understood. If there are still any doubts, please let me know them onto the comment section. I would definitely address those doubts. Meanwhile, subscribe to our channel NG Classes for more videos on signals and systems. Till then, thank you everyone for watching.